The Philippine President's chief legal counsel, Juan Ponce Enrile, is cleared by the Supreme Court of graft charges on the alleged misuse of government funds for coconut farmers. Enrile was among the accused in the Coconut Fund scam, which alleged that President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. and his cronies used the Coconut Industry Development Fund for their personal profit. A January 16th ruling by the High Court's First Division acquitted Enrile and several other directors of the United Coconut Planters Bank on the charge of allegedly siphoning off 840 million pesos from the funds in 1983. The court said Enrile's right to a speedy disposition of cases was violated. It was also the court's first division that previously granted Enrile's former AGG Reyes a temporary release from jail after nearly 9 years. Reyes is tagged in a multi-billion peso pork barrel scam. Enrile served as Marcos's senior defense chief and led a 1986 military revolt that ousted the late dictator. Enhanced security cooperation will be on the agenda as Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. visits Japan. Marcos arrived in Tokyo Wednesday afternoon to begin his five-day official working visit. He will be meeting with Emperor Naruhito and his wife, as well as Prime Minister Fumio Kishida. Matters of bilateral security and defense are expected to be tackled during Marcos's visit. Now, Japan is eyeing to help develop facilities of the Philippine Coast Guard, particularly putting up a Subic Bay support base.
Para sa Coast Guard, because naturally the reason behind all this is they would like to have more patrols along up and down the South China Sea. We can assure that the freedom of passage. So this is a new element to our relationship because we are now talking about security of the region.
Meanwhile, the president adds he is looking forward to sign a memorandum of cooperation with Japan in the field of agriculture.
That opens up Manila, hindi lamang the usual exchange of technology, but that's an important part of it. But also investment in agriculture and hopefully opening markets in Japan for our agricultural products.
Two more Japanese nationals detained at the Philippines Immigration Detention Facility have been deported. The fugitives, Yuki Watanabe and Tomonobu Saito, are said to be involved in scams targeting the elderly in Japan. On Tuesday, their companions and co-accused, Kyoto Imamura and Toshiya Fujita, were handed over to Japanese authorities. President Bongbong Marcos says their deportation was requested by the Japanese government.
Well, it was actually in the process already before the Japan trip was even planned. Nagkataon lang na it was just by coincidence that it happened. Of course, it did not hurt because it is a request. It was a request of the Japanese government, and so we were always going to acquiesce to that request. And we thought perhaps it would clear the decks, as it were, for the talks that we will have with the Japanese.
The death toll continuing to climb 3 days after a magnitude 7.8 earthquake hit Turkey and Syria. The Monday's tremor is now confirmed to have killed more than 12,000 people. Search teams from all over the world have joined local emergency personnel and finding survivors under the rubble of toppled buildings. A three-month state of emergency has been declared in 10 Turkish provinces, including Hatay. A Filipino community leader there has said five Filipinos are trapped under a collapsed building in the province. The three Filipino women were also said to be missing. The Philippine flag at the country's embassy in Ankara was hoisted at half-mast to show solidarity with Turkey. Turkish President Tayyip Erdogan concedes what he calls shortcomings in his government's response to the earthquake. Now, Erdogan visited disaster zones on Wednesday amid criticisms over the supposed slow official response to the tremor. The president admitted there were problems in the initial efforts, but he insisted it's not possible to be ready for such a disaster. He also gave the assurance all resources are being mobilized.